The Great Omar Rubaiyat, a lone jewel encrusted with over $20 zillion, now rests at the bottom of the North Atlantic, having sunk with the mighty Titanic. But I plucked it up from the depths. Amirata Sultana rushes over, intrigued by the original Great Omar Rubaiyat, created by Sangorski and Sutcliffe in 1911. She questions its condition, but I assure her it's intact and in perfect shape. She doubts its preservation, given its underwater ordeal. But I reveal that it's fairly dry, with just a hint of dampness, which I cured by putting it in my microwave oven. As she questions my credibility, I assure her that I do indeed possess the book, and I'm willing to retrieve it for display, along with a reproduction for public viewing. I describe the book's intricate details, from its semi-precious stones and 18-karat gold setting to the vivid illustrations by Elihu Vedder. The ornate binding, adorned with precious stones and elaborate designs, makes it a magnificent masterpiece. The Great Omar Rubaiyat is truly a treasure, with its rich history and exquisite craftsmanship. And though it may be presently lost in my basement lair, its allure and beauty remain timeless. Down it went into the black, watery abysm, resting in the oak casket of its prison. The specters of death and life's impermanence permeate Omar's quatrains, which themes thence are reflected in the tooling of the jeweled Rubaiyat, carried out by the firm of Sangorski and Sutcliffe. The front cover features a resplendent peacock motif, while the inside back cover centralizes the bony skull. Unlike the vaunted dead aboard the Titanic, the name of the great book lives on and on. Phoenix-like, the glorious peacock spreads his lustrous plumage through the years, in further irony and emulation of Khayyam. The Great Omar jewel-encrusted edition of the Rubaiyat needed three renditions. The first one went deep in the Atlantic, and the second was destroyed in the Blitz. Stanley Bray salvaged the precious jewels from the W.W. Tekka bombed-out bank vault, and by 1985 had made a third one, which remained safe in the British Library. That the first Great Omar Rubaiyat had gone down with the Titanic, and the second one burned, is all to do with the transience of human existence. My uncle was finishing up on a Titanic deep-sea documentary in 1987, and so had invited me to the site, after principal photography and filming had been wrapped completely. We sent the robot probe down for one last peep, on a special mission, into the depths of the deep, where the veiled lightning slept in its lonely keep. We viewed the wreck remotely, on a monitor. We saw death and decay sleeping everywhere. The probe entered a gaping hole in the hull, and we directed it toward the specie room, the place reserved for the more expensive, secret or official parcels crossing the Atlantic. Down, down, we are the bright forms beside thee. The probe's beam lit the way as we guided it by referring to a map of the mighty ship. Down, down, as the moth flies into the flame. In time, we found the secure metal box, hash 14, and grabbed it with the probe's robot arm, then carefully backed out the hardy probe, though the ship and on up to the surface. The box was watertight, the rust sealing it more. We cut through the lid, and there it brightly shone. We had the original of the Great Omar. Perhaps there was some extended discussion of literary treasures at dinner on the Titanic. On the fateful Sunday night of April 14, 1912, which sumptuous feast was hosted by the Widners, for Captain Smith was there, and a few more, alongside the bibliophile, Harry Wilkins Widner, who was bringing home many a festive jewel to festoon his already impressive collection. the ocean liner had sunk like a stone in the dark, after the iceberg had sliced all of its compartments, rousing the world to the nature of this fragile life. Down, down, as the bottom draws the stone, where death reigns over all that is known. Thank you.
you.